ओम साई राम एवरीवन, अ वार्म वेलकम ऑन अ फ्रेश डे टू श्री साई सच्चरित्र सीरीज। विद पैसेज ऑफ टाइम एंड डेज वी आर टेकिंग अप चैप्टर 21 टुडे, सो इट्स एन अचीवमेंट फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस। इन दिस चैप्टर हेमाडपंत जी हैज टेकन अप अ फ्यू टॉपिक्स लाइक वी एच ठाकुर, Anantrao Patankar and the Pandharpur leader. In this chapter, Hemadpant relates the stories of Vinayak Harishchandra Thakur, B.A., Anantrao Patankar of Pune and a pleader from Pandharpur. All these stories are very interesting, which, if very carefully read and grasped, will lead the readers on the spiritual path. Preliminary. It is a general rule that it is our good luck in the form of accumulation of merits of past births that enables us to seek the company of saints and benefit thereby. As an illustration of this rule, Hemadpant gives his own instance. He was a resident magistrate of Bandra, a suburb of Mumbai, for many years. A famous Mohammedan saint named Peer Maulana was living there, and many Hindus, Parsis and many others who followed different religion used to go to him and take his darshan. His mujawar, the priest, by name Yunus, pressed Hemadpant many a time for going to see him, but for one reason or the other, he was not able to see him. After many years, his turn came and he was called to Shirdi, where he was permanently enrolled in Sai Baba's darbar. Unfortunate fellows do not get such contact of the saints. It is only the fortunate ones that get it. Institution of saints. There have been institutions of saints in this world. From time immemorial, various saints appear, or rather incarnate themselves, in various places to carry out the missions allotted to them. But though they work in different places, they are, as it were, one. They work in unison under the common authority of the Almighty Lord, and know fully well what each of them is doing in his place, and supplement his work where necessary. An instance illustrating this is given here. When Thakur heard these significant words, which only he knew, he was overwhelmed with joy. He came to know that the word of the canary saint had turned true. Then joining both hands and placing his head on Baba's feet, he prayed that he should be accepted and blessed. Then Baba said, "What Appa told you was all right, but these things have to be practiced and lived. Mere reading won't do. You have to think and carry out what you read, otherwise it is of no use. Mere book learning without the grace of the Guru and self-realization is of no avail." The theoretical portion was read from the book, Vichar Sagar, by Thakur, but the practical way was shown to him at Shirdi. Another story is given here, which will bring out this truth more forcibly. Anantrao Patankar. One gentleman from Pune by name Anantrao Patankar wished to see Baba. He came to Shirdi and took Baba's darshan. His eyes were satisfied and he was much pleased. He fell at Baba's feet and after performing proper worship said to Baba, "I have read a lot, studied Vedas, Vedants and Upanishads and heard all the Puranas, but still I have not got any peace of mind, so I think all my reading was useless. Simple, ignorant, devout persons are better than myself. Unless the mind becomes calm, book learning is of no avail. I have heard from many people that you easily give peace of mind to so many people by your mere glance and potent word, so I have come here. Please take pity on me and bless me." Then Baba told him a parable, which was as follows. the parable of 9 balls of stool, Navavidha Bhakti. Once a merchant came here. Before him, a mare passed her stool, 9 balls of stool. The merchant, intent on his quest, spread the end of his dhotar and gathered all the 9 balls in it, and thus he got concentration of mind. Mr. Patankar could not make out the meaning of this story. So he asked Ganesh Damodar, alias Dada Khelkar, "What does Baba mean by this?" He replied, "I too do not know all that Baba says and means, but at his inspiration, I say what I come to know. The mare is God's grace, and the 9 balls excreted are the 9 forms or types of bhakti, which is Shravan, hearing, Kirtan, praying, Smaran, remembering, Padasevan, resorting to the feet, Archan, worship, Namaskar, bowing, Dasya, service, Sakhyam, friendship, Atmanivedan, surrender of the self. These are the 9 types of bhakti. If any of these is faithfully followed, Lord Hari will be pleased and manifest himself in the home of the devotee. All the sadhanas, which is jap, vocal worship, tap, penance, yoga practice, and studying the scriptures and expounding them are quite useless unless they are accompanied by bhakti, that is devotion. Knowledge of the Vedas or fame as a great dhyani and mere formal bhajan are of no avail. What is wanted is full devotion. Consider yourself as the merchant or seeker after the truth and be anxious and eager like him to collect or cultivate the 9 types of devotion. Then you will attain stability and peace of mind." Next day, Patankar went to Baba for salutation. He was asked whether he collected the 9 balls of stool. Then he said that he, being a poor fellow, should first be graced by Baba, and he would be able to collect them. Then Baba blessed and comforted him, saying that he would attain peace and welfare. After hearing this, Patankar became overjoyed and happy. The Pandharpur pleader. We shall close this chapter with a short story showing Baba's omniscience and his using it for correcting people and setting them on the right path. Once, a pleader from Pandharpur came to Shirdi, went to the masjid, saw Sai Baba, fell at his feet, and without being asked, offered some dakshina and sat in a corner, eager to hear the talk that was going on. Then Baba turned his face towards him and said, "How cunning people are. They fall at the feet, offer dakshina, but abuse behind me. Is it not amazing?" This cap, the remark here, fitted the pleader and he had to wear it. None understood the remark. The pleader grasped it but kept silent. When they returned to the vara, the pleader said to Kaka Sahib Dikshit, "What Baba remarked was perfectly right. The dart was aimed at me. It was a hint to me that I should not indulge in reviling or scandalizing others." When the sub-judge or munsif of Pandharpur, Mr. Noolkar, came and stayed here for the improvement of his health, a discussion about this matter was going on in the bar room at Pandharpur. It was said or discussed there whether the ailments from which the sub-judge suffered were ever likely to be got rid of without medicines by merely going after Sai Baba, whether it was proper for an educated man like the sub-judge to take recourse to such methods. The sub-judge was taken to task, that is, he was criticized, as also Sai Baba. "I also took part in this affair, and now Sai Baba showed his impropriety of my conduct. It is not a rebuke to me, but a favor, a lesson, that I should not indulge in any scandal or slander of others, and not interfere unnecessarily in others' affairs." Shirdi is about 50 kos from Pandharpur. Still, Baba, by his omniscience, knew what transpired there in the bar room. The intervening places, rivers, jungles, mountains, were no bar to his all-perceiving sight, and he could see or read the hearts of all, and there was nothing secret or veiled from him. Everything far or near was open and clear to him as broad as daylight. Let a man be far or near, he cannot avoid all the all-pervasing gaze of Sai Baba. From this incident, the pleader took the lesson that he should never speak ill of others or unnecessarily criticize them. Thus, his evil tendency was completely got rid of and he was set on the right path. Though the story refers to a pleader, still it is applicable to all. All should therefore take this lesson to the heart and benefit thereby. Sai Baba's greatness is unfathomable. So are his wonderful leelas. His life is also such, for he is Parabrahma, Almighty God incarnate. Bow to Shri Sai. Peace be to all. Om Sai Ram. I again express my gratitude to all the listeners of this Sri Sai Satcharitra Daily English series who are intently listening to this and are getting blessed. May Baba help all. May Baba bless all. Om Sai Ram.